Thank you for coming. My name is David Calloway, and today I'll be doing my persuasive speech on why not to choose the cheapest contractor, even though that's oftentimes a tempting thought. Now, the reason I want to speak about this is I've been doing construction for the past 5 years, and in that time I've seen a lot of people that said things like, oh, well, I met the man at church that said he was going to remodel my whole house for $5,000. And generally, those jobs get started. They get a quarter of the way through, and then they stop, and all of a sudden, you can't get a hold of someone. And all of a sudden, they stop showing up at your house, and all of a sudden, the work doesn't get done, or when it is done, it's falling apart within a few months. It's normally a horrible situation. So I want to give you some steps that you should take. And even though it seems like you'd want to use the cheaper of the options, even though it seems like maybe going around these points could save you money, maybe make your life easier, maybe make the job more valuable because you're getting the same work when you're not having to pay as much money, but to be honest, you're not. That's what I'm going to show you here today. So one of the largest things is, are they licensed? You can save a lot of money getting any project done in your home by not choosing a licensed contractor. Absolutely, every time. They may be able to cut their competitors' costs by hundreds of dollars or thousands of dollars, depending on the job. But the risk you run with saving that money is, what recourse do you have? If something happens, if something goes wrong, if for some reason the job isn't satisfactory, it's not completed at all, or they just skip town with your money, well, what recourse do you have? Because the state can't prosecute them. You, obviously, you can take them to civil court, but oftentimes those cases are difficult to resolve, expensive, time-consuming, if you can find the person. So even though it seems like, well, hey, I can just skip licensing and maybe I'll save a few hundred dollars here, it's probably not the best idea. Number two, you should probably get an insured contractor. Now, a lot of people say, I'm sure nothing will go wrong. You know, you can save money by getting someone that doesn't, they keep their overhead down by not paying for insurance. Very simple, very fast, very effective thing for the contractor to do to save money. The only problem is, what if the plumber is working on some copper gas lines that involve soldering? And they accidentally set your house on fire. Well, this is obviously a problem, and it sounds simple. It sounds like, oh no, I'm sure that's covered. You can try and file it under home insurance. That's going to cost you money. And either way, it's going to be a hellacious nightmare. So the simplest recourse is to make sure you have a work with contractors that carry enough insurance to cover your home. The company I worked with for years and years made a point to carry insurance twice the value of whatever home we worked on. That way we knew if anything ever happened, and we did have one instance where we needed to claim that insurance, and it saved our company $500,000. Now, if we hadn't had that insurance, I honestly could not tell you what the homeowner would have done, because there was an accident, and what do you do from that point on? So it saves you money in the long run. If you go ahead and take some of these steps, especially insurance, it's always a good idea to have insurance, even though it seems like something you may not need. And number three is, you want to find out how long they've been in business, because you go call a few numbers, get a few salesmen. This gentleman seems very slick. He offers you guarantees. He offers you warranties. He promises what his company can do. And where I worked HVAC, there are always many contractors. There are always many men working out of the backs of their trucks. And they offered great rates. They even said they offered warranties, things of that nature. But the problem is, they were never in business very long. And even in the case you purchase from a reputable contractor that deals through a larger company, whereas in HVAC, one of them is Carrier Corporation. Carrier Corporation offers labor warranties. They offer equipment warranties. They offer many warranties with the systems you purchase. The problem is, those warranties come through the manufacturer, or come through the dealer. It's kind of like car dealerships, where Ford makes the car, and you buy the car from a Ford dealer, but that Ford comes with a warranty that was given to you by the Ford dealer. So if that Ford dealer goes out of business, just like if HVAC business contractor goes out of business, then it doesn't matter what warranties you had, they're gone. That happens all the time because people buy from companies that have not been around for long. Maybe they've only been around a year, seemed like a great price, it was cheap. Company goes out of business, your system breaks, and you're left handing out money. So it takes that initial investment. I know it's always tempting because, I mean, it might be $1,000, it might be $2,000 more out of your pocket right then, but how much risk are you assuming? You always have to understand the risk that you're assuming. So number four is you need to, even though it's tempting to maybe not go with a written contract, maybe this guy's slick, maybe he seems trustworthy, once again, he's the cheapest, but you know, he's hesitant to give you a written contract, and you can try to justify, you can try to say that, well, he seems professional, he seems what he's talking about, he knows the right jargon, he can describe the problem, he understands what I want. You've got to get in writing. Even if the cheapest guy saves you thousands, but he's not willing to put it in writing, what's it worth? I mean, if you're going to buy a car, you want that car, you want that loan in writing. You're not going to just trust a dealer that you're going to give them that $1,000 down and you trust they're going to mail you that contract. You want it in writing that you're going to get the title to that vehicle. Same thing with construction. You need it in writing so that once again, you have recourse and you will have contractors that will walk away from you, that will not do the job, that will not be interested because they don't want to give you contracts. And to be honest, that's great. Those are the people you want to scare away. Number five, do they offer a guarantee? Now, earlier I'd said contractors can offer you guarantees and get out scot-free if they go out of business or if they disappear. And this is where the length and reputation of the company comes into play. This is where it's very important to find out, Has the company been around for 30 years, or they start up last week out of somebody's garage, and they're going to go out of business next week? Guarantees that give you, that are in writing, in the contract, can save you so much heartache, save you so much trouble, when you can force the contractor to fix these problems. And once again, the cheap guys, the lowest bidders, the guys that want to get in, get out, get your money, and be done, they're probably not going to offer you a lot of guarantees, at least not a lot of written ones. And it keeps their liability down, keeps their overhead down, lets them do poor work and get out quickly without being sued. You want to get away from that. Even though it's tempting, it costs more money, you still got to get away from those contractors. Number six, how many permits have they pulled? So this is going back to getting a reputable contractor. You need to speak to them about how many permits. And if they're hesitant to tell you, even if they're the lowest bidder, I promise you it's going to cost you more money in the end. Because if it's someone that's not pulled a lot of permits, they're probably doing a lot of illegal work. And illegal work is a problem for you when you try to sell the home. It's a problem for you because it may not have been installed right. It's a problem for you legally trying to resolve any issues. So not having a permit pulled is another situation where it hurts your bottom line if anything ever goes wrong by saving you a few dollars. So with all these points, what I want to ask you is it worth saving a few dollars just to get the work done? I mean, is getting the work done poorly worth saving $100, even $1,000? If you're going to invest several hundred or several thousand dollars, why not take the time to get it done right, to reduce your liability and have the job finished once and for all? That concludes my speech. Thank you. Please tell me you recorded that. Okay, I got scared. Yeah.